The space station's next crew heads to its launch site. New cargo launches to the station and getting ready for a first-of-its-kind crew rotation mission. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On September 27th, the space station's Expedition 64 crew, including our Kate Rubens, participated in traditional pre-launch ceremonies in Star City, Russia, then headed to the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to complete its training. Rubens and Russian cosmonauts Sergei Ryzhikov and Sergei Kutsverchkov are targeted to launch to the station October 14th. A Northrop Grumman Cygnus cargo spacecraft launched to the space station October 2nd from our Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. The Cygnus, loaded with nearly 8,000 pounds of research, crew supplies, and hardware, is named after late astronaut Kalpana Chawla, a member of the STS-107 crew that was lost in the Space Shuttle Columbia accident. On September 29th, we hosted a series of news conferences at our Johnson Space Center to preview NASA's SpaceX Crew-1 mission. It will be the first crew rotation mission to the International Space Station using a U.S. commercial spacecraft.
We're excited about the opportunity to name our vehicle. However, rather than wait until we got on orbit, we thought we would share that with you today. So without further ado, the Crew-1 Dragon capsule number 207 will henceforth be known by the call sign Resilient.
The mission is scheduled to launch from our Kennedy Space Center no earlier than October 31st. NASA's Hubble Space Telescope captured the images seen in this time lapse of a star some 70 million light years from us that first, in a moment of brilliance, goes supernova, then suddenly fades into oblivion. Supernovae like these can help astronomers measure the expansion of the universe. In light of the COVID-19 pandemic, the International Space Apps Challenge has gone all virtual for 2020. The theme of the October 2nd through 4th hackathon is Take Action. Participants use NASA data to address real-world problems on Earth and in space. Learn more, including about the winners of the recently concluded Space Apps COVID-19 Challenge, at spaceappschallenge.org. The new Planet Patrol website lets citizen scientists at home help NASA find exoplanets or worlds beyond our solar system by using data from our planet-hunting Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS. Over the course of a year, TESS collects hundreds of thousands of snapshots, each containing thousands of possible planets, too many for astronomers to examine without help. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.